Akashic records of bastard magic instructor. When I watched the first few episodes of this godly animated anime, I was hooked. It was funny and had a comical main character who hinted of having suffered a dark past. And it also had some pretty damn good fan service. It also had some weirdly epic scenes that I have re-watched many times and preached about it to all my friends. All in all, it had some darn good potential. Its first three episodes were enough to drag me out of the vicious cycle of reading some god-awful shonja or wuxia novels. Believe me when I say that this anime did me a huge favor, because those Chinese novels are long and repetitive as frick while somehow also being addicting. They were eating away at my brain cells. Anyway, back to the subject of matter. Things went downhill for the anime Akashic Records of the Bastard Magical Instructor, from episode 4 onwards. I mean, the whole big suspense and major source of excitement for the viewers after episode 3 was what was Glenn Radar's past job. And who was the girl from his memories that looked like adult Sistine. Now for the later, we did learn that the girl was Sarah and she was killed, and while the nature of relationship between Glenn and Sarah remains uncertain, they were close. Now with all those facts in place, you would think Sarah gets enough flashback screen time on the anime to make us feel for her. But actually no. We just get glimpse of Sarah here and there with her full face not visible, and we get a clear shot of her getting killed, and that's pretty much it. I don't know about the light novel, but at least in the anime where they could have made this character remarkable and quite loved, they just made her kind of a souvenir from Glenn's past. Now there is the question of Glenn's mysterious past, and while they did confirm that he did have a dark past where he killed countless people, famous, or rather infamous among the Imperial Corp. But the thing here is that while watching the anime, it almost felt like Glenn's reputation, or rather, the rumors about Glenn's power from the past, were exaggerated. It was like his reputation outdid himself. Cause after seeing him fight with his supposed true full strength, I just thought. Is that it? Is he not the secretly overpowered protagonist who just looks weak? I mean, I am all up for that too. But if that's the case, then why the frick are all the other characters treating Glenn as the secretly overpowered protagonist who is just faking being weak? I mean, he is obviously significantly weaker than Albert and Re equals L, who are his former colleagues. But those two do still treat Glenn with respect because of his supposed strength. I mean, I can get behind the idea of Fool's Arcana being the ultimate card, and him being an exceptionally skilled assassin. But how I am supposed to accept these claims when the main character literally almost dies every time he fights seriously? He would have died if Rumia didn't heal him, he would have died if Sistine didn't perform the revival. He would have been defeated, humiliated and killed by Jadis if Sistine didn't team up with him to beat Jadis Lofan. I mean, he has his badass moments too, but that's mostly just him being ruthless rather than him being overpowered. At least in my eyes, he doesn't live up to his reputation as the mage killer who supposedly defeated ridiculous amount of people in the past. He is a great teacher though. You have to give credit to this anime for making the characters so likable and them having such interesting chemistry between them, but the thing is, the plot isn't that good. Here is a fact. Episode 2 of the Akashic Records of the Bastard Magical Instructor is its best episode. Which is not good for an anime. An anime is supposed to get progressively better. Episode 2 has dark points, reveals the fact that Glenn is actually a great teacher, has some possible foreshadowing, and all in all has a great ending. In the progressive episodes, the good humor still remains, but with half-assed introduction of the new characters and plot points, and the lack of the development upon the interesting aspects that had already been introduced like Celicia or the Flying Castle, makes those arcs feel like a filler with a bad small-time villain. Plus, this series also has its weird moments where it suddenly goes in depth about the complex physics involved in magic. Which feels a bit out of the place in this anime, while also making it possible to make magic look like a drag. The anime wasn't bad, but with the start it had, I had more expectations of it. I would recommend it to anyone just to see some quality scenes from the first few episodes, but after that I won't be surprised if they got bored of it. But then there is the light novel too. With like 10 translated volumes, the anime left off at volume 6, so I might just flip through the rest of the volumes to see if the series ever did reach its initial potential.